So we're going to be seeing Ziep Wojcicki versus Gregson. Let's see how well Live with Dave can really deal with this. Double, of course, one of, if not the best breaks in the world right now. This is going to be absolutely intense right here. Live with Dave's really, really going to have to struggle to get through here. However, even if he does lose, he is still confirmed for a top 12. He'll just have to be on the loser's side. And he might still be able to pull it up. You never know. Anyway, probably the match. Double really testing the waters with his projectiles. Already has fun here, actually, using his Sunny Day to defend it in the first 10 seconds. Oh, nice place to whip right there. Oh, there's a grab
nice,
right there.
Nice crouch up with a counter
attack. Alright, so Lightning Dave right there didn't have a hard time getting in. But once he finds one way, dude. Oh, very nice job stalling in the air, actually, avoiding, like, say, sidewise and side beats. Double still one to get the most out of this field phase as he can. Lightning Dave going more aggressive. Nice grab right there, predicting field, I believe, is what I saw.
Yeah.
Despite the matchup, Live with Dave is doing significantly well. And he even has burst right here, trying to snag this out. Heat Wave, Oki, and Crab right there. Takes the first round over Double.
I think what Live was with Dave was recognizing how Double was shielding so much. He was gonna go for grabs because he knew Double was hoping to take a grab over a bunch of Blaze kicks.
Exactly, which usually would be the better option, but Live with Dave really, really recognized that. When you can take advantage of stuff like that, then it can really... And then, again, just like that, Double playing incredibly safe. Live Dave going incredibly aggressive.
Seeing a grab here for Double, though.
Yep. Things are getting this wall drag out. Actually, Double going in. Interesting choice. Not sure how much I agree with it. Oh, cross-up situation. Frog there, not quite comboing, though. Nope, the combo there. Flamethrower connecting. Now Live with Dave able to go with his first double on reaction, doing it as well. Alright, so this is a pretty serious streak for Double. Again, Double feeling very defensive with that shield. Maybe a bit too defensive. Oh, I think I saw sidewise. No, I did not. This is very scary.
Mars is trying to go.
And there we go! Live with Dave. What?
That was surprising.
Yeah. I must say, that was very smart what Live with Dave was doing. But I think he must have been Double, of course, very. I think he's a very safe player. Like, he definitely keeps his spacing and stuff like that. So he knew, like, I think Double was really expecting, like, more aggressive attacks. But those grabs, like, very smartly thrown in there, knowing when Double would expect pressure with attacks, but then instead just going straight for the grab. It was very, very smart.
Yeah.
Let's see if Double will catch on to this, or if he will fall victim to the same tricks that Live with Dave is doing here. So would you say that Emolga or Fennekin would really be more helpful here?
Depends on what you're going for. Because if you want to zone out, Emolga is your best option, but if you feel not confident enough in your zoning capabilities, then you'd probably want to go Fennekin.
Yeah. I mean, if there's anyone who'd be confident in their gonna kick those, I imagine it'd be Double.
Yeah. Oh, but now we see him getting in.
Right. Nice heat wave there. Ending with an attack.
Literally just did half of his health.
So what you saw, that was actually interesting, because he went for the non-EX Sky Uppercut. Even though EX would have done more damage, it also will cost him more health. So that was a more smart decision.
I think I labbed this one day. I think the non-EX version actually does more damage.
Oh, like in that situation?
Yeah.
Okay.
If I remember correctly.
Blaze kicks right there. Again, that's why I call that's exactly where the Blaze gets back. He lands at once, he's back in the lead.
Uh-huh. But Double's in rage now, potentially.
Very true. It also really affects your chip damage as well, so really just narrowing him down. He can zone him out for the next 25 seconds, which is definitely not out of the question.
Exactly.
And he also has Emolga up. If he can land that.
We see him not just randomly throwing out projectiles as much as he used to. He's trying to play it safe.
Alright, so they're able to snag that with the boomerang there. Double taking the first round. I think Double is running Winsu right there.
Yeah, it is.
Yeah. I think there is a lot of competitive viability to Winsu. He just
you just...
As long as you can deal with getting bad luck. But...
Yeah. As long as you can work around it.
Oh, not able to snag. One more thing on that counterattack right there. He's a burst right now, and Double not even fearing it anymore. He's taking the role that Live Day was taking before. I think he's like a lot less fear, but now Live Day's really taking advantage of that. There's a grab again right there, in the middle of the pressure. Again, so now he's in a pretty huge disadvantage. Now Live Day back in the lead, and still has his burst ready to go if he can get in.
Oh, just backline out. Oh,
that has projectile destroying properties. And he's going to push right there, getting that speed buff.
Double in a tough situation right now. He's got his situation though.
And he's going to go ahead and use that burst. Oh, right arm into the side beam, but able to fall for that trap right there. Nice baiting by Double, using the back dash, and getting the grab right there. Why would they take this to round three, getting it to a match point right now. A bit too risky of a sunny day off when Double went for there. Alright, let's see. See what happens. There's a lot of people walking inside. This is a big match. Alright, so Double taking the first field right there. Oh, it's a long spot. This is going to be a good amount of damage with the Sunny Day. Oh man, the jump actually is projecting. How much hit right there?
He's projecting a grab there, but he went for heat wave instead.
I would say really doing a good job conditioning Double right now.
Nice invincibility turns off of him.
Nice timing on it. Now that speed debuff really hurt Blaze again. Double already at first right now, and he's gonna go ahead and use it.
Into the crossbar. Into the
crossbar. Oh, yeah, that is going to be it. Just like that, Double going absolutely crazy on Live Day right there, going very aggressive at time run. Live Day having a hard time adapting to it. Now we're going into game three right now. Let's see. First, I think Double is more getting accustomed to Live Day. I think it's really looking to be in his area, but I don't know. Why would they still get his stuff in? It's making it close.
Yeah.
Adapting back and forth to which one will best fit.
Getting that
fire. That fire spin, really big old projectile that fight, basically have a hard time getting over. Goes for again, Double really going for much more of a zoning strategy right now. They just have a hard time getting in right now. Togekiss is going to help out with that though, if he can get good movement. Snagging that CDC. Double really just playing it heavy on the projectiles, and why would they have a hard time finding the answers? Oh, this is gonna be a cool combo. Ah, it dropped the show. Oh, light screen there. Yeah, so heat wave actually counts as a projectile, so therefore light screen can't beat it.
I was thinking that heat wave would actually go through the counter frame, but
it must be like frame one after counter.
I think so, yeah.
Alright, so now Live Day sitting at some very low health right now. Not find any way in.
Putting so much pressure with the projectiles.
Exactly.
And then just boomerang up and pushing him out.
Is this exact kind of strategy that can make this matchup so hard from Blaze Kid? A relentless amount. So now.
Yeah, I think Live Day recognizes.
Yep, he knew that there was no way he was getting through that. He's gonna have to go in with maybe a different strategy or something like that. Go hyper aggressive and try and get something in. Just like that, he's gonna go Togekiss right off the bat. Still needs to be careful to not fall for what Double is throwing out.
Gonna get a fire spin out.
Ooh, and
get some damage.
I have a Dave in a really tight situation right now. Already at half his health.
We see him flipping out with the JWAP. We're just seeing trying to run away from Live Day.
Can't even get the place kicked all up. Honestly, looking very grim for Live with Dave right now. Double just running train right now. Finally finding his footing. And just putting on so much against Live with Dave. Very, very difficult.
Look at that shield pressure.
I know, like there's almost absolutely nothing to do right there. Double just a commanding victory right there. Turning it around just like that. It's kind of like what I think about, like Double had like a different playstyle each game.